Welcome to the spoken tutorial on KV Online Admission Conducting Lotteries. In this tutorial, we will discuss the process of conducting various lotteries in Teachers Dashboard. This video is intended for admission in charge of KV. Open the Teachers Portal. On the web page in the login section, type the user ID for your school. Enter the password. Type the CAPTCHA code displayed here. Click on the Login button. The school's interface opens with dashboard. Let us see how various lotteries can be conducted. Click on the lottery link in the left menu. Notice the various categories of lotteries listed here. The sequence of conducting lotteries for a particular school is also displayed here. For demonstration, I am taking example for the Project IHL category KV IIT Powai, Mumbai. Kindly note, civil and defense sector schools follow a slightly different sequence for conducting lotteries. For each school, the correct sequence of conducting lotteries will be automatically displayed in the left menu. Please follow this sequence when conducting lotteries. RTE lottery is the first in the sequence, hence it must be conducted first. RTE lottery must be conducted only on the date and time slot given for the school. Lotteries for other categories can be conducted at any time in the given sequence only after conducting the RTE lottery. These lotteries will be enabled only after the RTE lottery is conducted. Please note, these lotteries can be conducted only once for each category. Click on the RTE lottery link. The page opens. Scheduled date and time for conducting this lottery is displayed on the top of the page. Information about number of sections available and number of RTE seats available in this category is also mentioned. If your school's time slot is in the future, come back to conduct the RTE lottery in the allotted time. If your time slot has already expired, please contact KVS headquarters. Request them for an alternative time slot for RTE lottery. Number of sections available and number of RTE seats available is also displayed here. Eligible RTE applicants pre-lottery list with total number of applicants is shown here. This is a dummy demonstration. All applications shown here are dummy applications. Each application is given a pre-lottery sequence number as shown in this column. Pre-lottery sequence number has no effect on the final position of an applicant in the list after the lottery is conducted. Show this sequence number to the parents. Here are the corresponding application submission codes and names of the applicants. Search button is available on the top right corner. To find the name of the applicant in the list, type the name in the search box. The application with the name is displayed. Please demonstrate this feature to the parents. Clear the search box to display the full list again. If you want to download this list, click on Download Pre-Lottery List button. This button is provided at the top right corner of the page. In the dialog box, select Save File option and click on OK button to save this list. Conduct RTE lottery button is seen on the top right corner. Conduct RTE lottery button will be enabled only on the predetermined day and time. This button can be clicked only once. After clicking the RTE lottery button, the button will disappear. The lottery cannot be conducted again. Once you are ready, click on Conduct RTE Lottery button. A box with a message appears. Read the message. There are two buttons available here, Cancel and OK. Click on the Cancel button if you want to cancel the conducting lottery and return to the page. If you are ready to conduct the lottery, click on OK button. Wait for a few seconds. At the top of the page, date and time on which RTE lottery was conducted is indicated. This process will reshuffle the sequence of applications randomly. Here are columns for pre-lottery sequence numbers, application submission code, name, post-lottery sequence number, admission status, and remarks. Show the post-lottery sequence numbers and pre-lottery sequence numbers to parents. There are two more columns on the right side, admission status and remarks. These columns need to be filled after the documents are checked for each applicant. Demonstration of the marking admission process is shown in another tutorial. Scroll down the page. Notice that the waiting list applications are marked. These are marked after the allotted RT applications are filled. The number here is 40. Hence, waiting list applications are marked from 41st application. Please note that an applicant may have different waiting list numbers in different admission categories. Scroll up and read the important message about waiting list. Scroll up the page. Click on Download RT Lottery Result button at the top right corner. In the dialog box, select Save File option and click on the OK button. The post-shuffle PDF downloads to Downloads folder. Here I have opened the RT Lottery post-shuffle PDF. This can be printed and used for displaying. Close the PDF. Let me show a few more examples of conducting lotteries. Next in the sequence is differently abled SC Lottery. Click on the link. This lottery can be performed only after you perform the RT Lottery. The date and time at which the lottery can be performed is mentioned at the top of the page. You will also find the following information. Number of sections. Number of horizontally reserved, differently abled or DA seats under SC category. DA-SC applicants within top 40 of RT lottery. Total number of eligible, differently abled SC category applications is given here. Scroll down. Show to parents the pre-lottery list and pre-lottery serial numbers of all applicants. In this demonstration, there is only one DA-SC candidate and conducting a lottery may appear redundant. However, the lottery must mandatorily be conducted even if there is only one applicant before admissions can be given in this category. In the case of your school, there may be more than one applicant in this category. When you are ready to conduct the lottery, click on Conduct Lottery button. Read the message and click on OK button. Wait for a few seconds. A new list is displayed on the page. Show the post-lottery and pre-lottery sequence numbers to parents. Here there is only one application in this category, hence there is no waiting list. This may be different in your case. Now conduct all the lotteries given in the sequence here. For demonstration, I have conducted lotteries for differently abled ST lottery, differently abled OBC NCL lottery, differently abled general OBC CL lottery. Next, I will demonstrate service category 1 lottery. Click on the link from the left panel. At the top of the page, information about total number of seats, number of sections in each class, and total number of seats reserved is displayed. The seats reserved in each category, RTE, DA, and SAQ are also displayed. The number of seats available in this category will be 160 minus 66. This will be 94. Total number of applications in this category is given here. All the applications eligible under this category are listed here. Show the pre-lottery sequence numbers to parents. For each applicant, service category, service subcategory are also displayed. When you are ready to conduct the lottery, click on Conduct Lottery button. Read the message and click on OK button. The reshuffling of applications takes place. Show the post-lottery and pre-lottery sequence numbers to the parents. Scroll down the list of applications. Since the number of available seats in this category is 94, The waiting list starts from sequence number 95. Download the post lottery list by clicking on Download Lottery Result button as shown earlier. Lotteries in other categories shown in the left menu can be conducted in exactly the same way at any time after the RTE lottery is conducted and in the sequence indicated in the left menu. However, the lottery for each category can be conducted only once. The sequence in which lotteries are to be conducted appear in the left menu and are exactly as approved by Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. This may differ from school to school depending on whether the school is in IHL project category or civil defense category. The sequence of lotteries as in the left menu should be strictly followed. This completes the demonstration of conducting lotteries on KV portal. The process of marking admission status for the selected applications is shown in another video. The Spoken Tutorial project is funded by MHRD Government of India. This video is created by Snehalata Kaliappan and Madhuri Ganpati from Spoken Tutorial Project, IIT Bombay. Thank you for watching.